Let's get an update on the weather now from Pagasa forecaster Veronica Torres. Good morning, Veronica.
Good morning to you and all of our audience at ENC. Currently, easterlies is affecting Luzon and the eastern section of Visayas. So for now, we're expecting partly cloudy to cloudy skies with chances of localized thunderstorms over Metro Manila and the rest of the country. We don't have any gale warning raised over any part of the country, and we're not monitoring any low-pressure area or tropical cyclone near or inside the Philippine area of responsibility. And that's the latest from Pagasa Weather Forecasting Center. Veronica C. Torres reporting.
Thank you very much for the update, Veronica. China again blaming the Philippines for another collision at sea. Beijing accuses a Philippine Fisheries Bureau vessel of sailing dangerously in China's waters and seriously threatening fishing boats. But the BFAR says the Chinese maritime militia vessel deliberately collided with BRP Datu Kabaylo while it was on patrol near Sandy Cays off Pag-asa Island. The Philippine vessel sustained minor damage.
Hindi natin maikakaila na isa na naman itong pagkakataon na kung saan nakompromiso ang kaligtasan ng ating mga tauhan sa ating barko na mapayapa lamang na ginagawa ang mandato ng Bureau of Fisheries and Aquatic Resources na magmanman sa mga katubigang sakop ng Pilipinas.
The incident happened days after the ASEAN summit in Laos, where President Marcos called out Beijing's aggressive actions in the South China Sea. Philippine and U.S. Marines launched drills in the northern and western parts of the country Tuesday. More than 2,000 troops from 9 countries joined the 2024 exercises dubbed Kamandag, with the addition of 3 new observer nations: France, Thailand, and Indonesia. But the Marine forces clarify the military drills are not directed at any country.
It has nothing to do with whatever is happening in the region. This exercise basically focuses on our main objective, which is to foster good relations, to enhance interoperability, and of course to strengthen our ties with our partner nations.
We planned this exercise well in advance, and this is, like the Commandant said, the 8th iteration of this. And so this exercise, regardless of what's going on geopolitically, is going to happen, and it's to benefit really the Philippine Marine Corps, our partners and allies in the region, to come together to get better, to respond to anything.
Still, the Philippines says the exercises could potentially be used to facilitate the evacuation of over 150,000 Filipinos from Taiwan in the event of a conflict. The joint exercises happened just a day after China held huge drills around Taiwan, which is directly above the Philippine province of Batanes.
Any crisis occurring in Taiwan would involve our concern to our OFWs in Taiwan. And I think it's more of a preparing our forces whenever there will be repatriation of our OFWs. We are not exercising to join the fight if there will be any fight in that part of the region.
The Kamandag exercises will run until October 25th. Around 460 overseas Filipino workers have been repatriated from Lebanon since Hezbollah forces there have come under Israeli attack. Philippine Migrant Workers Secretary Hans Leo Kakdak says 256 others are set to come home via commercial flights until October 28th. Another 250 are awaiting clearance from Lebanese immigration. Kakdak says the Philippines will ramp up repatriation efforts should it upgrade its alert level for Lebanon.
Of course, it would be quicker to put a group of OFWs together and board them on a chartered flight, or as the president said, on a flight that would based on mobilized government resources and assets. So we stand ready to repatriate OFWs in the event of mandatory repatriation or alert level 4.
The House Quad Committee will attempt to trace the source of cash rewards allegedly given to policemen who killed drug suspects during the Duterte drug war. One possibility, the money coming from the intel funds of former President Rodrigo Duterte. Vivian Gulia reports.
The House Quadcom will investigate whether former President Rodrigo Duterte's intelligence funds were used to reward cops who killed drug suspects in his administration's war on drugs. Quadcom co-chair and Santa Rosa City Representative Dan Fernandez says this was prompted by the revelation of retired police officer and former PCSO General Manager Roina Garma, who implicated Duterte on the alleged reward system for his drug war. Garma told the mega panel that the reward ranged from 20,000 pesos to 1 million pesos, depending on the status of the suspected drug personality.
Roina Garma told us na doon ang galing sa Malacanang yung pera. So we need to find out saan talaga kinuha yung pera. And we're pretty sure doon yun, sa intel fund.
The Quadcom plans to compare the timing of releases from the Office of the President's Intelligence Funds with the drug-related killings from 2016 to 2022. Fernandez said the Joint House panel will invite representatives from the Commission on Audit and check the documents pertaining to the utilization of the OP's intel funds for the said period.
Especially doon sa panahon na ano, alam mo yung panahon ng may pinatay ng mga Chinese doon sa Davao, eh, di ba? Yung tatlo. O baka, well, baka doon nang galing, hindi mo yung moment na transfer yung pera, baka rin lumakita. Yun yung mga titingnan natin sa Quadcom.
Duterte's former aide and incumbent Senator Bongo insisted on Monday that the alleged reward system does not exist. Then Philippine National Police Chief and incumbent Senator Ronald De La Rosa also denied implementing such system in the PNP.
Wala pong reward system na umiiral sa kanyang opisina. Suporta, sinusuportahan niya po ang kapulisan kung anong pwede niyang isuporta para magampanan po nila ang kanilang tungkulin.
Yun ang mahirap kapag sa outside tayo nagsasalita. We can say anything that we wanted. But of course, kapag nandun na tayo sa hearing, andun na yung repercussion that you will be, cases can be filed against you dahil nga, syempre, ano na tayo, under oath na po tayo. Itong kaila Roina Garma, this was under oath.
Fernandez denied allegations that the Quadcom's investigation is a demolition job, adding that no affidavit issued by a resource person was made under duress. For Solicitor General Minardo Guevara, he says the Quadcom has already done much of what the International Criminal Court investigator intends to do. He also says the Quadcom can turn over the evidence it gathered to proper government agencies in charge of investigation and prosecution. Guevara further argued this move will be aligned with the government's position that the ICC has no jurisdiction over the Philippines and that domestic institutions could handle the prosecution of crimes related to Duterte's war on drugs. Vivian Gulia, ABS-CBN News.
Police in the southern Philippine city of Davao are on the hunt for former Duterte spokesman Harry Roque. He has been hiding since a Joint House Committee ordered his arrest for contempt over a month ago. The Philippine National Police believes Roque may be hiding in Davao City, the hometown of former President Rodrigo Duterte. The Philippine Immigration Bureau confirmed on Tuesday Roque's wife, Myla, already left the country on September 3rd. She was said to have flown to Singapore. This was nearly 2 weeks before the Bureau issued a lookout bulletin for her. Like her husband, she's also the subject of an arrest order of the House Quad Committee.
Miss Myla Roque po is out of the country since September 3. Her lookout bulletin was issued on September 16. So wala po siya sa bansa sa kasalukuyan.
Philippine police are set to file criminal complaints against two of its former officers over the 2020 assassination of a state lottery official. The Police Criminal Investigation and Detection Group will file murder and frustrated murder charges against former Police Colonel Royina Garma and former Police Commissioner Idelberto Leonardo. The two were tagged by anti-narcotics police officer Santi Mendoza as the masterminds in the ambush slay of Wesley Barayuga. Mendoza will also be included in the complaints along with dismissed police officer Nelson Mariano, Staff Sergeant Jeremy Causapin, and the unnamed gunman. The lawyer of suspected drug lord Kerwin Espinosa slams Senator Ronald De La Rosa for threatening his client. Attorney Raymond Palad says it is unbecoming of a sitting senator to make threats of physical harm against a witness. Espinosa earlier accused De La Rosa of pursuing him, of rather pressuring him to link a former Senator Leila De Lima to the illegal drug trade. Bato was the country's police chief at the time. He has denied the claims by casting doubt on Espinosa's credibility.
These are the witnesses na ginamit nila to prove yung illegal drug trade charges against Senator De Lima. Tapos ngayon na nagbaliktara na itong mga tao na to on the ground that they were coerced, sasabihin niya hindi credible. So parang conflicting mismo yung salaysay ni Senator Bato. Nung napapakinabangan niya, credible. Ngayon bumaliktad na, sasabihin niya hindi credible.
A joint law enforcement team fails to retrieve an electronic device from a Philippine offshore gaming hub allegedly owned by arrested Chinese businessman Lin Chun-Huan. Operatives of the police and the Presidential Anti-Organized Commission inspected Lin's property in Binyan, Laguna. But all they found there were dismantled computers with missing hard drives. Authorities suspect the gaming hub's operators have already destroyed evidence related to their scamming activities. Lin was arrested last week at a residential subdivision in Laguna. He is suspected to be the mastermind behind illegal offshore gaming operations in the Philippines.
Nasimot yung hard drive. So wala nang digital evidence. Pati documentary evidence, wala, lahat sinimot nila. So this is a scene of the crime that has basically been wiped clean.
PAOK also bared Tuesday it's going after 100 small illegal gambling hubs, which remain operational across the country. It says the small POGO operators were once part of larger units that dissolved after the government doubled down on its crackdown of the crime-riddled industry.